morning. So last class we started with the new concept or new topic which was called as union executive. So already regarding the union executive, and in that one character we started discussing, so that was president. So last class we talked like qualifications, elections of president, tenure of the president, and removal of the president by using an impeachment method. And we also discussed in the previous class one of the most important topic of the lesson, so that will be powers and functions of the president. So in that last class we discussed about one most important the powers and function, so that was legislative powers. So that we had discussed it in the previous class. So today's class we will be going with three more powers and functions of the president. So that will be executive powers and discretionary powers and emergency powers. So those are the three most important the powers which we are going to discuss in the today's class. So let's go one by one. So the first and foremost is that is executive powers. Okay, so this executive powers, okay, what is this executive powers? If you see the completely the executive powers of the president, or completely the executive of our, I mean the power of a president, it completely speaks about appointments of a president. That means who can receive an appointment from the president. Okay, so that is the being a head of the executive, being the nominal head of the country, the president is plays a very important key post in appointing the different categories of personalities. Okay, and I have mentioned here, I mean few categories of the personality whom the president appoints. Okay, so in that first and foremost we are having is that is the prime minister. Okay, the prime minister and the council of ministers of our country being appointed by the president of India. And the second, the most important the appointments which the president does is that is Chief Justice of High Court and Supreme Court and judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts all over our country. So will be appointed by president only. So that will be the second executive power. And the third one, if you see, appointments or appoints governor of states, of all the states, then chief commissioners of the union territories, union territories of a country, then also appoints the chairman and the members of an UPSC, that is Union Public Service Commission of our country. Okay, that is also will be appointed by the president. Okay, so that will be the third. And the fourth one, if you see, the last one, appoints the Comptroller, Auditor General of India, the Attorney General of India, the Chairman and the members of Planning Commission, and the Chairman and the members of Economic Commission. Okay, so these are all the major appointments of our country, so which the President does. That is the reason the President, we call it as who plays a very important key post or the key role in the appointing the different categories of personalities in our country. So that's we call it as an executive powers of our president. So that's the second one we are having. And the third one we are having, so that is discretionary powers. Some special powers where president, this is completely speaks about the appoint. And here, one's own decision, where president can take one's own decision, that is discretionary powers, okay, where he can take his own decision, one's own decision. some special powers. So what if you see, when no political party wins the required majority in the Lok Sabha election, okay, when no political party wins the required majority of the seats in the Lok Sabha election to form the government, during that time the president is the person who takes one's own decision for the formation of coalitional government. Okay, coalitional government, two political different political parties so coming together and forming a coalitional government. Now before in Karnataka, I mean the Yediyurappa's government, we had the formation of JDS and Congress. They had formed the coalitional, like that in central also. When both the parties, or when the parties gets an equal number of votes. Okay, so during that time, the president is the person who sees that the formation of coalitional government takes up with the help of two political parties. So that complete decision is given to the president of our country. And the second one, if you see, when the government loses the support, when the ruling party or when the ruling government loses the support in the majority in Lok Sabha, the president is the one who calls that house is dissolved. Then we will go for midterm election. Okay, so that is also announcing of that government gets dissolved, and we will go for a midterm election. That is also will be under the control of president. And the next one, if you see, the president has got completely in a non-money bill, that is ordinary bill of the government, which when it is sent to him for the reconsideration, he may ask that particular bill to once again to reconsider, he may send it. And at the same time, if he feels that particular bill is not important for such situation or such, right situation, so he can keep that bill. Okay, no member of parliament has got, right to question him. Okay, so these are the three discretionary powers of a president, so which we are, having it. Okay, so that's the one aspect, so which we are having it. And next, if you see the fourth one, so that is the emergency powers. Okay, so very important, the powers and functions of president, so which we are, having it in our country. So as you all know, okay, I hope you all know, when the constitutional framers framed the constitution, so they also made it, that the constitution should be, in constitution itself, they have entrusted that the president is the person who has got enormous power with regard to proclamation of emergency in India. Okay, so already those who formed the constitution, their constitution framers, they already have said that. Okay, in India, the president is the one who is given completely the enormous power in proclaiming an emergency. Okay, then at that situation, the constitution framers also have said, what are the emergencies that can be proclaimed in our country? Okay, according to the Indian constitution and according to the Indian framers, so we are having three emergencies which can be proclaimed by a president in our country. Okay, so which are the three, if you see, according to the three, one is, that is, first one is, we call it as a national emergency. Okay, so national emergency is nothing but a threat to our country or threat to security of our country. Such situation, the president can proclaim an emergency. So what kind of threat? If you see, a threat like a war between the two countries, okay, or is armed rebellion, or entry of a terrorist, so like this, armed rebellion, or anything. So like these are all called as a threat to the security of India. Such situation, the president can proclaim an emergency in our country. The second one we are having, so that will be called as a state emergency. When there is a constitutional breakdown, okay, so during the situation, to that particular state, the emergency can be proclaimed by the president. Okay, firstly, the constitution breakdown, you can see it in a state when the political parties, between the political parties, when there is a clash or when the political parties loses the support. So during that time, the emergency can be proclaimed. And the third one we are having, so that is financial emergency. That is economic, I mean, if the financial stability of our country is in danger, where the economic progress in our country is not going in a proper way or proper manner, if president feels, okay, so that time he can proclaim a financial emergency. Okay, so these are the three types of emergency where the president can proclaim in our country. Okay, let us say one by one, just a few basic information. If you see here, the first one is the emergency due to the threat to the security of India, which is also known as national emergency. And this emergency is proclaimed in our country, I mean, by an president. And when president, when he proclaims the national emergency, the parliament will be having 1 month. Okay, the parliament will be having 1 month to approve the proclamation of emergency by a president or to cancel it. Once if they approve the emergency proclaimed by a president, its duration in our country is 6 months. And that particular emergency will be continued for 6 months. Then after 6 months, suppose we have not overcome that crisis or overcome the problem, then again 6 months it will be continued. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, a national emergency can be proclaimed by a president. And once the national emergency is proclaimed, within a 1 month, the parliament should approve the emergency proclaimed by a president with the presence of a session. And once if they agree this particular emergency, the duration of emergency is 6 months. And when the national emergency is proclaimed, okay, so when national emergency is proclaimed in our country, the changes which can take place is, the first and foremost changes, the president becomes the sole administrator of our country. The entire administration of our country will be placed under the control of president. That is the first changes takes up. And the second changes, we are having is, that is, the fundamental rights of a people can be suspended, especially the freedom of movement, moving from one place to another place. That change will be taking place. And the third one we are having is, suppose when the emergency is proclaimed, in the central government, if the Lok Sabha term is over for 5 years, now already the 5 years is over, next we have to go for the new Lok Sabha election. But the emergency is taking place in our country. Such situation, Lok Sabha's tenure can be extended for one more year. Okay, whenever the national emergency is proclaimed, suppose the tenure of the Lok Sabha gets over, then it can be continued for one more year. This third changes can, take place. Then president can alter all the financial matters of all the states in our country. He can alter it as the president is required. Okay, that's the one aspect so which we are having it. And at the same time, it can also interfere in the state list lawmaking procedure. So we studied in Union Parliament, so different types of list, union list, concurrent state list. So during that time, the parliament also can interfere. Okay, parliament call also interfere in the state list. Okay, that is the entire. Okay, that is the one aspect. Now present situation only you can take it. That is corona. This one emergency was proclaimed. So you know, the complete national emergency was proclaimed. The entire country was under the control of, the central government was controlling the entire. So like that, particularly changes can take. So that's the changes we can take. Then second one we are having, that is the emergency due to the breakdown of constitutional machinery. Okay, when the particular state, the political functioning is not taking place properly, then state emergency can be proclaimed only in that particular state. Okay, such situation when it is approved, within a 2 months, the approval of the state emergency, should take place. Okay, state emergency should be approved by the parliament, so with a simple majority, within 2 months. Once if that approval is done, even the duration is 6 months. Okay, during that emergency is proclaimed, the changes that can take place in a particular state is the entire the state government functioning will be placed under the, I mean entire state administration will be placed under the president. Okay, so president will be taking care of the state, but on the name of a president, the governor will be the person who will be taking care of the particular state. That is the first case. Second one is there will be a possibility where the particular the house, the ruling party which was there in that particular state can have a dissolve of the house, and where we will go for a new election where he can suspend. Okay, that is the one aspect which we are take place. And at the same time, the next and foremost we are having is that is some of the provisions which is there in our country, some of the provisions which is there in that particular place, the powers which is given to the people can be suspended by the, especially from the High Court. So where we are having it. So that is the one more changes. So which we are having it. And the last one we are having, that is a financial emergency. So when the financial emergency is proclaimed, it should be approved with the 2 months. 2 months duration, the financial emergency has to be, approved. And there is no fixed duration like this. Within this, no. Till we, there is no fixed duration till we revoke. Or till we revoke the financial the crisis, so we can continue the financial emergency. So in our country, but national emergency, state emergency. Okay, in India we have proclaimed many times, but financial emergency till today we have not proclaimed in our country. So that is the reason no financial emergency is proclaimed in our country till now. Okay, that's the one aspect. So which we are having it. Suppose in future if it is proclaimed, the changes that can take place, the effects of financial emergency which we are having is, one is a new financial commission will be appointed by the president for the, cross-check of the financial. And the second one is, whatever the salaries and the allowance which is being given to the all the, government, the officials, so that can be, reduced, even the salaries of the top officials. Okay, salaries of the top officials like Supreme Court, High Court judges also can be reduced. And even the president may say the even a state to utilize the funds in a manner where he thinks according to his wish. Even a state financial matter also can be functioned by a president. And that is the one aspect, so which where we are having it. But till today, the national emergency and the state's emergency, we have it. But financial emergency, so which we have not proclaimed. So that's about the powers and functions of the president, so which we are having it. So here we complete the lesson, that is Union Executive. So next class, so we will go with the new lesson or new concept. So that will be the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers. So one more concept. So under this one, we are going to discuss. Thank you.